Hello, folks. Welcome back to the madness that is Pit People. As always, I'm Falcon, your host, joined by my friend, as I said in the last episode. Say hello, you crazy monkey.
Don't tell me what to do.
Yeah, him. My friend, the punching Chris. He was the same individual who was playing with me more recently, in the Divinity Original Sin that we eventually need to go back and do, you know, sometime. Maybe. folks, please like the video. It helps it be more popular on YouTube, get more views, blah, blah, blah. Subscribe if you enjoy my content, want to support the channel. And please check out my Patreon. You can find the link for that top right of the screen, the description below, and at the end of the video. And gives you a variety of different things. So, there is apparently one main quest in the game, which Chris has already done. So I cannot presently do that, apparently, because he tries to sabotage me, because he's a crazy bastard like that. But I will do that off-camera, or not off-camera, but a different episode without co-op and show you. Or maybe he can select his other save file and we can play it there. Whatever. But for the time being, we're going to go forward with one of these side quests. Now you can see, one of them here is listed as part two. That is the only actual, like, primary side quest that we have done. Off-camera, all the rest of them we have not really attempted. Although we have done a few, like, in-the-overworld side quests as well, but nothing real too serious. So, let's do the thing with that guy, because fuck not. Now you unselected it, crazy bastard.
You declared me a saboteur. I have to live up to it.
Apparently. So, if you're playing multiplayer, the cart thing that you wander around the countryside in, one of you drives and the other one gets to use the artillery stun option. At this particular moment, I am the one driving and Chris is doing the artillery support. Also, as you can possibly tell, the map is actually randomized every time you make a new save file. So, like, this map is very different from the one we were just on at the end of last episode. Also, you can get a lot of money by just wandering around and picking up the coins. Is that the thing that we're looking for? Shiny.
Yeah. I mean...
Now recruiting. Wants you to recruit a Gorgon.
Interesting.
I mean, why the hell not?
It's not what we're supposed to be doing, but, you know.
Pile of mice. I need to unload on somebody. Do you want it? Not really? What do we do with a mice pile? Yeah, pretty much.
Asking the real questions.
Good point. We find me a wild Gorgon and bring her back. What the hell are we doing with a Gorgon? Their hair has got to get hungry pretty regularly. There, but what now?
Oh, I always wanted to be a statue.
Their hair? What? I'm lost. Very, very lost.
Come on, man. Classic mythology, Gorgon. There's another name for Medusa, or that's the kind of thing that she was.
Gorgons and Medusa are not necessarily the same thing, though. I mean, sometimes, but...
I mean, yeah.
Okay, so... I guess this is the main quest thing that we were going on.
Yeah, the other one's in the complete opposite direction. Ooh, a car.
Car. We already have a quest, though, so we can't do that one. We'll do the main quest for the moment, since we're here now. Are you sure this is the place? Yeah. We used to sit right here, baking in the sun. It smells bananas! That and strawberry. Yeah, we thought he was so amazing. Nobody ever drooled over me like that.
It's concerning.
Which for anyways with a cage icon, sincerely. Mr. Whispers. Okay. About what's his face? The Bridgeside Bandit. Oh, him. He's only my friend because of the health bonus. Hold on, there's a receipt here. Balloons! Gift wrap! Berry Delicious Cake with Happy B-Day Dolph on it. Berry Delicious? But that's Scrum's mix. Come on, we can probably smell his trail if we're quick. Whatever the hell you say there, friend, you're just freaking crazy, but... So apparently, yeah, we already have a quest. That's what I thought. He's fine. We can do it. Yeah. Watch for enemies. Oh, maybe a Gorgon. Okay, yeah, whatever.
Did you, like, brain dump that we already talked to him?
Oh, yeah, no, I was wondering... I guess there isn't necessarily a specific location. I guess it has a, you just would need to find a Gorgon and bring it to him. Coins! I don't know, maybe we'll get lucky and we'll be able to accomplish both missions at once.
Somehow I doubt it, but okay.
I mean, who knows? Pick up all the coins. I need money. I spent all of my money on cages because why the hell not?
Any idea what a Gorgon would look like in this game?
Who the hell knows?
You want me to, like, blast these guys? Or... Oh, really?
Too late.
Okay.
Oh, jeez. Yeah, also, fights are significantly larger if you have... when you're in co-op mode. Which, you know, makes sense, I suppose. But, yeah. Okay, so I have all the same people that you basically saw in the previous episode, with the exception of my little bird guy here. He does a little buff in the area around him, and he also does reasonable melee damage. Not that great, but it's not terrible. Chris has... what's the other... what's the number, the sixth guy that you have? Oh yeah, he has this flying pixie guy who can do like a... explosive ranged attack on enemies.
And it's just fire magic. Don't dress it up.
I mean...
to be fair, it's like a hazard to everyone involved.
Yeah, it does. It can hurt friendlies, which, you know, it's always fun. Always good times. My my ranged guy over here, my Yosef, is also equipped with an artillery cannon who also can hurt friendlies because, you know, what's a fun game without some friendly fire? No, they have one of the pixie guys too.
Like Frilly Billy, who's had the whale on your guy. Oh no, I guess he's stunned. Never mind.
Yeah, he got stunned by the my sword. It has like a stun effect on it. Oh, my my healer is about to get wailed on pretty hard, though. It's okay. We can intercept. No, you can't quite move where I want you to move. That's okay, I guess. You stay right there, and you stay right there, and there we go. So these larger fights, especially in the co-op mode, they do get pretty chaotic. It's hard to tell what the hell's going on sometimes. Because it's just people everywhere blowing up and blasting and slashing and madness.
I don't like mushrooms. Just throwing that out there.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they're kind of a pain in the ass. When I say kind of, I mean absolutely.
What did those mushrooms ever do to you?
Well, I mean, I'll have to take my word for it.
Oh, I won't. Oh man, they have two pixies? Shit. So what you're telling me, if we capture anything out of this mission, it should be a mushroom.
I mean, you know, you want to have a member of your party that's basically a suicide runner.
So, why, what do they do?
Yeah, that. They fart on people.
Oh, good.
It's great.
I mean, I'm down for fart explosions. Who isn't down for fart explosions? I mean, really.
Me. Not a fan.
Oh, you're just no fun.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not.
How you doing over there? Yeah, you got them pretty handled. The majority of the enemies seem to be concentrated on me, but
this guy in the diving helmet just taunted us.
Yeah.
He has to die.
He's going to pay for it dearly. Very soon. Very soon he shall suffer. Hey, you! With the farting! Fuck you! Actually, no. Let's leave you guys where you are. So I really need to heal you. You're fine where you're at. Although, actually, no, you're not. You need to move, because I need you. Problem is, with the artillery guy, is he's likely to do more damage to the friends than he is enemies half the time, so you can position him certain ways to make it more likely that he'll attack certain enemies, but it's difficult sometimes. Got explosions everywhere. All my people are getting tore up pretty good here in the middle. We need to focus on trying to take out the mushrooms, I think. That's best possible, anyway. There we go, got him. Although I think I lost my, Yeah, I lost a couple people. We're back at your house like it never happened.
Oh, that's comforting, I guess. Oh,
okay, so if you lose people, you can go back to house and get them back, but the revive potion is so you can resurrect them in battle, I guess.
Hmm.
So I actually lost two people. I lost both my Pipistrella and my mascot guy. Which is no bueno. Definitely no bueno. Oh, because the mushrooms, when they died, everything just like exploded like epically in the area there. It just killed everything. That's not good. I done got my ass kicked that time. Your healer's not in a good spot.
Yep. He's gonna get worse, too.
Although, they seem to be a little focused on trying to blow me up, though, at the moment, so you might actually not be too bad off, but...
Yeah. It's probably fine.
No, you need to stay over here. Dare taunt us, we shall explode too. Hey. Try not to have that guy blow all everyone up. Guy has a helmet down here, so I can definitely use some, if you have a person who's got...
I've only got the one. With blunt.
Oh, and she's, like, on the other side of the damn area, so... Mm-hmm. Well, most of the enemies are dead now.
Yeah, but we're not gonna have two of your people going into the other missions that we need to do.
Yeah, that's a problem. Definitely a problem. I mean, I've been in the process of trying to pull them back, but they sure as hell did not move fast enough.
Yeah.
Congratulations, you did next to nothing. Good job. There, I opened up a spot so your other person that is down there can get around this guy. That way we can take this guy out faster. You continue to pursue the other one. There he goes. Alright. Yeah, the losing Pipistrella is definitely bad. The mozzarella I'm less concerned about, but... I was gonna say, if this gives us 3 stars, I call bullshit. Because we lost 2 people.
Yeah, not important.
Okay. Well. And if you go back, you end up canceling your missions and stuff, don't you?
Yeah, you do.
Shit. Although I guess we wouldn't really suffer too badly for doing that, but in reality. What do you think? Should we go forward or should we go back?
I do not care. Oh, hello. Oh, go over to the right.
Yeah, just trying to figure out how they'll even get there. Oh, look, one of the spider thingies.
Not a fan.
The hell? Dude, flying around to the...
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. See, the cage thing is the means that there's a... One of the guys that we're looking for is in that group. I don't know. Do you think we should try and do that one? Because the Sugar Chaperone is like a story thing, so that'll just reset, and we can come back and do that one later.
That's true. We might as well, then.
And we'll try and capture this thing and see if we can do that.
We're all gonna die.
Yeah, probably. Well, it's a little death. Fine.
You can't engage while it's stunned?
Nope.
That's kind of nice.
Except when you want to engage on it, then it's a problem.
Well, yeah.
That was what he asked for. Oh, the snake thing. Okay. I see.
Wait, where?
Snake. See snake?
Oh,
snake,
yeah.
Snake lady.
Cool.
Looks like she has a turd on her head.
Well, you know, I wasn't going to say anything.
Ugh, two more of these fucking mushroom things. I don't know if they're the same mushroom. Mushrooms, but... I think I'm gonna try and fall back to your position a little bit. My people are reasonably hurt, so. We should sit there for the moment so you can attack more. But... Kaboom! Kaboom! Plus, you know, we can artillery them to death.
This is true.
Very slowly, but, you know. If we can force them into a really good choke points or whatever, we might be...
Try and throw a net on that one.
Fairly well off. Which one are you throwing a net on? The one we're supposed to throw a net on?
Yeah. Well... And again, like, it's giving me the cage icon, but it's blue.
Yeah, I think it just means... Oh,
right.
It,
it's just the mouse.
It just, it's just telling us that's the one that we need to capture, so...
Well... There. That way I can net the right one.
Yeah, it's just gonna net him, though. Like, we can't cap... It has to be the one that we leave alive and capture at the end.
Right, but that, that leaves them immobile.
True.
Puts them at the back of the line. At least temporarily.
Alright, if you want to move up with your people and reinforce me up here, maybe we can cut into them and stop them from getting around us. Or because our two net people here hopefully will net both of the guys in the front and it'll delay their entire line. Hmm. Because they won't be able to get past those two guys. That just, like, freezes the whole front line there.
What just happened?
Ow! Bad things. Bad things happen.
I'm serious. What just happened? I have no idea.
Alright, get your healer up here and we'll kind of try to hold the front line basically and do our best to try to stop them from getting past the position here. They have no healer, and we have done a fair bit of damage with the artillery and stuff already, so... Okay. Sure, dude. Whatever you say. Ow. Flames and death everywhere.
Duly noted.
Need to swap positions with your person there for a second. Leave you there for the moment. pull you up there. You should be fine where you are. You're fine where you are. Okay. What are you doing in the middle there? You just swapping our guys, or?
What's that? Yeah, I'm moving people around.
Oh, okay. He's fine. You're doing a lot of damage to him with our artillery and flame attacks and stuff. It's actually good right now because the Gorgon thing has been forced into the back, so...
This whole situation is just retarded.
Let's see. Who is hurt the worst moment? I mean, everybody's hurt bad, actually, right now, so...
Yeah.
Stay right there. Yeah, it's fine. You can stay right where you're at. You're fine. I think everybody's mostly okay for the moment. You just have to be careful with the, when the mushrooms explode, because that's what happened last time when we got...
Yeah.
Also, the more southern of the two mushrooms there. Looks like he's like zombie mushroom or something. He's got blood all over his.
No, one of them went. Something went down. There we go. Triple kill,
yes. Careful engaging on the Gorgon there.
Yeah, I know. Just trying to pull my main guy back.
I don't think I want you to attack that one. Yeah, if you move right there, you should be okay. Yeah, you're fine where you are. Did their pixie guy run away? Yeah, he did. Okay. Got their stupid other mushroom. Now it's just the pixie is still alive. Oh no! Yeah. And they have a mascot. Didn't see the mascot there.
Flames.
Okay, I told you guys gonna shoot at the mascot, because that's the only thing I can shoot at with the way I've got him positioned now. You really need to be healed some before I send you into battle again. I guess you can go down over there. Okay. And who the hell am I selecting? Oh, Sophia. Can't really do anything with you. Can't really do anything with you right now. Send you right there, I guess. Or you'll net one of the guys and... Oh, well. Try and net one of the guys.
Sweet. Down the last one.
And your one person died, though.
Wait, what are you talking about?
Your leader person.
Oh. He'll live.
It's like he's dead. He'll live. He's fine. Don't worry about it.
Yeah. You throw in the cage, or
yep.
I guess you're the one with the cages, so.
Yep.
I'm not gonna do much of anything.
He's doing what now? Oh, you're fine. Okay. Toss! Capture! Yay! completed. Upon taking any damage at all, the Gorgon has a chance to spawn a snake. Gorgons have up to three snakes simultaneously. I don't think we ever saw that.
Nope.
It's acid from range. Lady's cursed by a jealous goddess. No known weakness.
Cool.
Yeah, sure. I don't think we saw the snake ability at all, so it must be a... Oh, maybe it's like melee range, because we never did a melee range of all the damage that she took was some ranged attacks.
Yep.
Yeah, see, your Horatio got his ass blown up.
Apparently my pixie did all of the damage.
Damn. Yeah, your pixie and my my artillery guy, like, that was the entirety of the damage done to the enemy team.
Yeah.
Probably to ourselves, too, because, you know. Alright, so now we have to go back to the dude, so I guess we will do that. We'll come back to do the main quest thing, because we have definitely probably stunned that thing to make sure it doesn't attack us. Being attacked right now would probably not be good. No. None of that. None of that, you wee little bastard.
Hey,
oh, there's another one. Right next to the dude. Ah, how about those mice? I think I feed my hair mice? It's really dumb. So you don't want them? What? No, give them here. I might get hungry later. Jeez.
Okay.
Yay, mission complete. Now we have to go back to town because we're badly, badly in trouble. which means we'll probably have to ride up again to the other place, but that's okay.
Replanted upon more fertile grounds. I'm going to make myself cry. That was beautiful. I should be a poet.
Yeah, that happens a lot.
Yes. Yes, it does.
Ooh.
Cyber gun? I want a cyber gun. I got the sub hat.
It's a phone cord as
yeah.
A sword.
Steak knife, backup plan, melon pilot.
This is my new shield.
Which one? No, the light.
Traffic light.
Traffic light. For no good damn reason. Because why not? The house has been digested. Aw. Yeah, well, that's too bad. But okay, back at the house. We need to do some updates real quick. Totally going to switch over to. Oh, I guess I have to. I guess I'm stuck with the hat for the present moment.
That looks so derpy.
Oh, it's a bigger sword. It's one of the big ones.
Yeah.
So it does a little more damage. I have the bill. You see the bill? Oh boy. I don't know that I can do a whole lot really in customization rise at the moment, because most of the things that I would want to switch to can't really use. I'm gonna switch you over to fire the resistance though. Actually, not you. Because you're barely ever in combat, so let's do that. Let's switch you over to fire resistance. Oh, you don't have enough weight. Crap. Oh well. Well, never mind. Mm. Did you? Oh yeah, you still have the net on your other person. If you want to swap that out.
Oh, I had a good point.
So is this considered a large character? It is. Yeah. Crap.
Yeah.
I kind of figured it would be. Curious what kind of things she could have though.
Taffy.
Toilet brush. Fairly ridiculous. Well, yeah, see, the big guys, I have a bunch of big guys now. I've got the big, one of the big ogres, I've got the hair troll, and I've got this thing, but I don't know that I want them because they take up two slots. What do you think?
Are you talking to me?
Yeah, you.
Yeah, I don't know. Oops.
No, you got the
what's that?
The raptor head on the one.
Oh yeah. Hang on a sec, I'll be right back.
Okay. And that's actually going to be it for this episode anyway, folks. So I will see you, shall see you in the next one. So take it easy. Have a good day. And thank you for watching. I need to buy a new cage. Replace the one that I used. And yeah, we will see you next time. Take it easy, folks. Bye-bye.